my name's Tim Muriello. I'm the fitness and supplement expert for I'llPumpYouUp.com, your favorite online supplement store. You know, I've been in the game for some time. I've actually done 20 different bodybuilding contests. I've done powerlifting shows. I've done a strongman contest. I've actually started competing when I was 16 years old. And like I said, I've been in the game for some time. And you know what? I've tried all different types of supplements, man. I've got some supplements that I like, some supplements that I'm not going to spend my money on and I don't take. And you know what, though? When it comes to getting a pump, okay, I think I've pretty much narrowed it down to a science for at least myself, okay? Now, what I do may not work for you, but it is what I've worked up and the plan of action I have definitely works for me. So I just wanted to share a couple different things that maybe you can try to help you get a better pump, but definitely some things that are my favorite things to do to get an awesome, awesome pump. After years and years of experimenting, think again, I got it down to a science, all right? Now, let's cover these. The first thing, guys, is water. You got it, water. Dude, listen, you should be drinking. If you're training hard, you're lifting, you know, 3 to 5 times a week, you gotta be chugging water, all right? Don't let people crack on you. Don't let people get on you for carrying a gallon of water to the gym or everywhere you go. Dude, you should be drinking 1 to 2 gallons of water a day. I drink 1 to 2 gallons of water every single day. And when I know I've gotta work out at like 5:30, 6 o'clock, dude, I am chugging water, all right? What does water do for a pump? I'm gonna tell you why, all right? Water helps give your blood more volume, okay? That's where you're gonna get really good pumps from, okay? Once you get the blood in there, it's gonna be a lot stronger pumps because you have more weight to your blood because of the water. Number two favorite thing I like to do to get a pump is take a favorite supplement of mine, ingredient of mine, which is L-citrulline or citrulline malate. Now, notice I didn't say arginine. What you will find is a lot of supplement companies, they're really starting to wean off the whole arginine thing, okay? And they're starting to incorporate more citrulline malate in there. You'll see, look at all the pre-workouts out there, they're starting to add more and more citrulline malate in there, okay? I love citrulline malate. In my opinion, for my body type, for me, my workouts, L-citrulline has been the best hemodilator for me. It's relaxed my blood vessels and opens up the floodgates where all that blood can easily go into my system. It gives me good pumps and it gives me lasting pumps. So very, very important. Next is sodium, okay, or salt. Now wait, before you start typing in the comments, oh, this dude's talking bro science, man. Listen, if you know any bodybuilders, okay, guys that have been on stage that have actually competed, ask them, say, hey man, what do you take before you get on stage? I guarantee you they're gonna say trail mix or a Hershey's bar or something like that. What are they trying to do? They're trying to get salt, man. They're trying to get salt into your system. When you get more salt into your system, that's when you get real good vascularity. Well, you'll see, man, I'm telling you, even supplement companies, they're starting to put a little bit of salt into their pre-workouts to help you get a better pump and to help you get more vascularity. Salt, sodium is water soluble. It carries that water into your muscles for greater blood volume and weight. Next on the list is carbs, carbohydrates. Now I know what you've been told, stay away from carbs, you gotta stay lean, dude. You gotta get shredded, you can't eat any carbs. Well man, you know, when you're dieting, yeah, lower your carbs a little bit, but if you're in the off season, man, you gotta have carbs. The carbs are very important and very integral part of getting a pump. And if you know anything about nutrition, you'll know that 1 gram of carbohydrate holds 3 grams of water, adding what? You got it, more weight, more volume to your muscles. You need muscles to be stored up and filled up with glycogen, stored up carbohydrates to have really, really swelling pumps, okay? Next on the list is very simple, high rep burnouts, okay? I'm not saying do all your workouts high rep, but I will say this, okay? You will notice, and I've talked to strongman people, you don't really get a huge pump from low reps. You get strong, don't get me wrong, sets of 3, sets of 5, things like that, you do get strong, but you don't get that really good pump, man. That's why when I work out, I always try to do a burnout at the end of each body part. For instance, if I'm doing chest, at the end of my chest workout, I will superset like push-ups with cable crossovers, 5 sets of 25 reps. more and more and more blood, because that pump is going to expand the fascia, okay? It's going to expand the fascia. It's going to get more and more blood into your system when you do those high reps like that. And that blood is so precious, man. It's healing blood. It carries nutrients to hungry, starving muscles. So remember, water, citrulline, malate, sodium, carbs, and high rep burnout sets, all right? Appreciate your time. Check out all our videos. Don't forget to subscribe.